your boy the prime. And that's the person be. Yeah, yeah. Real shit here, here. A real story, South Bronx shit. Come follow me now. In 1970, 9 to rock for fun, hoping to become a celebrity rap star. Some said I stink, cause they didn't think that it would go that far. 10 years old, all I wanted was in the morning at a jam. And damn, man, they run it many times they would throw jam. When I finally got it, that was started to slow jam. When they got it, your hype said, drop the mic. Wanna rhyme maybe next time, but not tonight. So I wrote extra hard, the crowd got into me, just mentally electric guard. The same suckers that used to rock in front of, used to jock, you wanted me to go loose a lot. They used to come around town, down, but sound all wild, found that they found out the standard is down. A lot of rubbish rappers were getting all whack, while I still rap the cause of a city known. I felt like everybody was running out, so I'm playing me saying, DJ, when you coming out? Come to run around, some people would tell me things like, make it bigger, all it did was sell me dreams. Then I met my man, the almighty KG. Him and me, a real chill and still tight. I got down with the knee, the hypnotic. Perform on all the stage with a mighty psychotic. I always wanted to perform in a bird's eye view of people who come to see you like at the LQ. I owe a lot of thanks to Aaron V. Cause when it got hooked up, the brother looked up. Me, Anthony, yes, my best friend. You can check it with that record called After Homicides Begin. In 88, the styles we were running down. And the music, no other used to but running now. We got a lot of rep and respect for brothers and sisters. Those that do